Lo, I see four men loose walking in the midst of the fire, and they have no hurt. And the form of the fourth is like the Son of God. God himself stepped in that fiery furnace. So underscore, the fourth is like the Son of God. So God, again, manifests himself in a temporary manifestation of theophany. And when they brought them out of the fiery furnace, there was not even the smell of smoke on them. The hair was not even singed, and the ropes had been burned free. Nebuchadnezzar basically was converted because of that in the end result. Under this verse 25, write Romans 8 and 3. Well, before you go there, let's do this. Under Daniel 3:25, write in there Exodus 3:2. And we won't particularly turn there right now, but God appeared to Moses as fire in a burning bush, and a voice spoke out of the fire. So there again, God appeared in theophany form. So we know that was a doctrinal thing. It was not an unusual thing for God to do this. How can we say that? How can we prove that? Because in the mouth of two or three witnesses shall every word be established. He did it four times here, we're talking about. But there, under that verse, Daniel 3:25, right in there, Exodus 3:2, but then also wrote, write Romans 8:3, and turn to Romans 8:3. Romans 8 and 3. Here the Bible says plainly in Romans 8 and 3, the apostle writing, for what the law could not do, in that it was weak through the flesh, God sending his own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh, and for sin, condemned sin in the flesh. After that verse, write in there Hebrews 9:22. Hebrews 9:22. Hebrews 9:22. Here in Hebrews 9:22, here is the crux of the whole matter. Here it says in 22, and almost all things are by the law purged with blood, and without shedding of blood is no remission. There's no remission of sins without the shedding of blood. So you need to underscore there, without shedding of blood is no remission. And then write under verse 22, Hebrews 2:14-16. And turn back to the second chapter of the book of Hebrews and look at verses 14 and 16. Are you beginning to understand something? I hope you are. Or that you will really understand this at the end of the school sessions. Can you see why some people do not find truth? You can't find what you don't want to find. You can't see what you don't want to see. If you just read carefully through the scriptures, as I said, the Bible reveals itself. It's the greatest commentary upon itself. If you can read a newspaper, I reiterate again tonight, you can read the Bible and understand. powerful. In fact, I think the most beautiful thing in the entire world is a hungry soul. Just give me a hungry soul, and I'll help them get the Holy Ghost. If they're really hungry for God, it's tremendous. Look at verse 14 in Hebrews 2. For as much then as the children are partakers of flesh and blood, he also himself likewise took part of the same, underscore that much in that verse. For as much then as the children are partakers of flesh and blood, he also himself likewise took part of the same. And verse 16 says, for verily, or truly, he took not on him the nature of angels. In other words, he didn't become a spiritual creature, but he took on him the seed of Abraham. He became flesh. When the Messiah came, when God came into the world, he came in body, Emmanuel, not just an ethereal, gossamer, angelic creature or form. The Bible says he took on him the seed of Abraham. So underscore all of verse 16. For truly, he took not on him the nature of angels, but he took on him the seed of Abraham. And then right in there below or above that verse, Hebrews 10 and verse 5. Hebrews 10 and 5. And turn back to Hebrews 10 and 5. And as we're going through this, going back and forth through the scriptures, the Bible says, here a little, there a little, line upon line, precept upon precept. The Bible is like a gigantic jigsaw puzzle. If you just take a puzzle, no matter how beautiful the picture is on the front, take it home and dump it out on the table, where do you begin? But if you start working with the individual pieces, and just keep working with them, you'll find a piece here that fits this. And you'll find a piece over here that fits this. And you keep working with it, and the picture begins to form. And if you keep working with it, in the end, you will complete an incredible picture, just like on the cover of the box. This Bible is like a gigantic jigsaw puzzle. If you'll just begin to work with the pieces or the verses, all of a sudden, this fits here, and this fits here. And at the end result, God will give you a panoramic view of his dealing with mankind from Adam all the way through the timeline to the very end, when the last person that can be saved will be saved, and the last person that can be lost or will be lost is lost. That's why it's so vitally important to study the Bible and to work with the pieces. Are you getting a picture? It's tremendous. Now, here in Hebrews 10 and 5, look how obvious this is. Wherefore, when he cometh into the world, when who cometh into the world? Jesus. He saith, sacrifice and offering thou wouldest not, but a body, underscore the word body, hast thou prepared me. A body hast thou prepared me. In other words, in the New Testament, wherever you see the word son, you can temporarily, in your mind, lift the word son out and put the word body in, because that's really what it is. A body hast thou prepared for me. In other words, in that setting then, for God so loved the world, that he gave his only begotten body, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. The picture becomes so clear, it becomes powerful, that God would have loved us to die for us. So after verse 5, put in there Acts 20 and 28, and turn back to Acts 20 and verse 28. Acts 20. And verse 28. Acts 20, verse 28. Here Paul is writing to the church, and he's saying here, take heed, in verse 28, Acts 20, 28, take heed, therefore, unto yourselves, and to all the flock, over the which the Holy Ghost hath made you overseers, underscore this, to feed the church of God, which he hath purchased with his own blood. It does not say which he purchased with the blood of a son, a second person in the Godhead. The Bible says here, which he purchased, God, which he purchased with his own blood. Under that verse, right in there, Isaiah 9 and 6. And before you can turn there, and then I'll say something to you. Isaiah 9 and 6. I love this verse. I've always loved it, as long as I can remember. But back to Acts 20 and 28, the Bible says, the church which God purchased with his own blood. If God so loved the world that he sent his son, a second person of the Godhead, to die, to be sacrificed for the sins of humanity, then the Creator instituted child sacrifice, which was a total abomination to God. Powerful. Isaiah 9 and 6 says, for unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder. His name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Everyone say amen. Under Isaiah 9, 6, right in there, Luke 1, 35. And turn to Luke 1:35. The understanding of the oneness of God is the greatest understanding, as far as I'm concerned, that can come to a human being. The greatest revelation, the greatest understanding that there is only one God. The devil doesn't care how many gods you serve, as long as you don't serve the one true God. That is the most fearful thing to him, because that's where the power is. And if you know the name